You know, Republicans are saying there was some kind of political shenanigans going on. You've heard more of the testimony than we have. What do you think?
There's never been any evidence to back that up. It was clear that the intelligence community at the outset got it wrong. Their assessment at the time, and this included General Petraeus when he initially met with us, they thought that there was a protest out in front of the consulate. They thought that the violence took place either during the protest or after the protest. Yes, there were militants involved. Yes, there were terrorists involved, but they thought it began spontaneously. We now know there was no protest. But it's certainly not accurate to say or suggest, as some of my colleagues have, that the White House was trying to politicize this.
Hold on a second. You say we now know there was no protest. How long do you think it took us to know there was no protest? How long do you think it took for us to know there was no protest?
Well, I think probably the best evidence that we got was when we finally obtained the video evidence, and that took some time.
Even then, that
took, I think, probably at least a week to 10 days.
Let's say it took 10 days. 14 days after the event, President Obama was on The View, and he was still using the word mob as if to suggest somehow there was a crowd. That's why Republicans are all upset about this. And they may be right or wrong, but I think you have to admit they have some reason to be a little either confused or irritated that this kept being, that this mythology kept going out there when the facts seemed to say otherwise.
Well, the DNI clapper did issue a statement expressing basically that they had gotten it wrong in the initial assessment, that there wasn't a protest. But there are a lot of conflicting intelligence reports about, even now, about whether there was a protest there, about what the motivations were and were they motivated about retaliation for the death of one of their leaders. Was it related to 9/11? Was it related to Cairo? Was it related to the video? And I think probably the truth of the matter is there were a great many people involved in this attack, and some were motivated by all of the above. But the idea...
Hold on a second, Congressman. That sounds like you're going back to the line that somehow this was a protest. And now, you've already said the intelligence community said they got it wrong. This was a planned attack on 9/11 on a U.S. diplomat.
Well,
correct?
First of all, there is no definitive conclusion yet that this was a pre-planned attack. And that is one of the key issues, not whether we call it terrorism or extremism. Clearly, it's a terrorist act when you're firing mortars and RPGs. The real question was, how much was this planned in advance and who was responsible? The intelligence community didn't know that when they first addressed us. We are still trying to get to the bottom of the degree to which it was pre-planned and whether we should have seen any of this coming. But to suggest, as some have, that there was a deliberate effort to manipulate the intelligence or mischaracterize it simply isn't the case. And what the general said today was the changes that were made in the multi-agency process of coming up with those talking points, they were changed in order to protect classified sources of information. And the general made it clear there was no interference from the White House. He also made it clear, and I asked him about this, since the statements that our ambassador made on those Sunday talk shows followed immediately after, really the morning after the afternoon, which we got the talking points, that reflected the best assessment of the intelligence community at the time that could be shared without revealing potentially classified sources of information. That was what the general said today. And for those who suggest that her talking points were watered down or changed for some malicious purpose or that she knew better, that is simply not the case. And it's inconsistent with what the general told us. It's inconsistent with what the acting director Morrell told us. But I think some people are clinging to this theory developed during the presidential campaign and refuse to let it go, notwithstanding all the facts to the contrary.
Well, and although I think you have to admit, if officials have said from the beginning, we don't know, instead of speculating, we wouldn't be here, would we?
Well, they were being bombarded, frankly, by all of us on the committee who wanted to know, who wanted answers, who was responsible, how did this start, how did it get out of control. And they warned us that their initial assessments were just that and were going to change as we gather more intelligence. Maybe, frankly, many of us on the committee should have listened more carefully when they said they didn't know the answer to some of these questions, but this was their best initial assessment.
All right.